Yep, if you go to this ni.com/solutions, okay, they actually work very closely with partners, industry partners, as well as academic institutions like Ngee Ann. Okay, Ngee Ann. Now I tell you, almost all the polys, almost all the poly will be using this LabVIEW in their institution. Also university, NTU, NUS. Okay, I can tell you there is a module that they are doing. So students are using LabVIEW. So it's become very proliferate. That means very widely used. So you can see that over here, my question is this, what are the areas, right? So you can see who are using LabVIEW. So I want to list down by industry. No need to write all, just write a few. Okay, what are the areas? So you can see that aerospace, you have automotive. Currently, I have a project, my final year project student. We are working with Panasonic. You know Panasonic? This company, right? Also on automotive. So we are using LabVIEW. Okay, then I have another project we can share with you. We work with another resort in Singapore, Sentosa Siloso Beach Resort. They wanted to do some automation. So we now in the final phase, we finished the project already. We're going to bring this project, all done using LabVIEW. We are going to bring to their resort and test it there. Yeah, something like that. Then there will be, they want to put some publicity, so there will be media, journalists coming to interview. Something like that. Okay, so these are real stuff that the industry wants. Okay, how we can help them. I think the point is we must add value. Yeah, okay. So for example, there are other sectors. Singapore Power, okay, and all the oil and gas and the different sectors. Okay, you can see it's a very wide area, superly wide. Okay, this one can go by application also. Okay, your LabVIEW, where is it being used? Oh, yeah, these are the different applications. Okay, can be from machine to, you know, data logging, and so on. Quite a few. Solar also now, Solar. So these are the sectors. So you can list down some examples. Okay, inside your question 6. Yes, correct. What are the areas of application? Okay, you can put down. Oh, looks like you're all game to finish early, then go home, go back early, right? So far, you all go for lunch. Okay, can, no problem. I'll work with you. We'll target ourselves. We'll finish. Okay, great. Okay, any questions so far? Okay, can. Is it okay? Wow, you're very fast, You're very good. Okay, if you are quite happy, question 6 done, right? Question 7. Shall we take a look at question 7? Okay, in which we have a little exercise for you. Yep, let's take a look. So I can close my PowerPoint. This one. Now, I would suggest, before you go to question 7, right? Okay, now, these things that I've created, you have this PowerPoint, right? I would suggest that you can please take a look before you come for next lesson. Okay, this one, all the little clips that I've prepared. No need to log in one, just click on it, you can view it. Go and take a look. Is it okay? There are about maybe four videos on this about LabVIEW. I think it will be highly encouraged to go and take a look before you come for the next lesson, which is next week, right? So that it will help you understand, and then you can do the activity in the class. Okay, so that is for something to take note. You see this guy, right? This guy is an engineer with NI on Vinit. This gentleman here. So he got some short video. You can watch it. Okay, before you come for the next class. But not finished yet. We try to finish the exercise 7. Okay, the last activity, right? This one. Last but one. Okay, this one. Okay, we need to try to build this. Okay, now what this activity does is that question 7. Okay, we ask you to construct a simple program. It's very simple. Very simple. You can do it in about less than 10 minutes. Okay, you can roughly see if you turn to page 5. if you turn to page 5, you can see that what they're trying to do is that we have a little program here that converts your time in seconds to the respective hour, minutes, and seconds. You know what I mean? Basically, let's say if you look at the screen there, page 5, the front panel screenshot there. Okay, let's say if I give you a time in seconds, maybe 32,200 seconds, right? I want to convert that into hours and minutes. So it's quite simple, right? Seconds to hours, what do you do? Yeah, how do you convert? What do you do? Seconds convert to hours. Is it times or divide?
Divide
by? 60. Ah, correct, 60. Because 1 hour is 60 minutes, right? And 1 minute is 60 seconds. So in other words, you will take the seconds, you divide by 60 times 60, right? Or divide by 3,600, right? Am I right? Because 60 times 60 is 3,600. So you refer to the block diagram in the middle of the screenshot there. Do you see this? The picture, look at your lab sheet, page 5, and the middle screenshot, right? We want to build this one very simply, very fast one. Yeah. Okay, let's try and do it together. Okay, so what I need your help, okay, is to close this one. If you have not already done so, just now the scope one, close the program, close, no need to save. This one you got, do you all save this one? Not yet. You save it? If you want, you can save, but it's quite a simple program. If you don't save, I won't blame you. Right, this is a simple program. If you want, you can save. Go to file, you can save as. Okay? But I know you're now running on the desktop, right? You're not running on your laptop. So if you save it, then where do you save? You save to the school's desktop. Am I right? You know what I mean? Unless you all got thumb drive, you all work already, then you all can copy the file, then. That's the reason why I suggest that you must try to use a laptop, because you can save it onto your machine, your own machine, your own hard disk. Okay, if you want save, save as, I'm okay with that. Okay, if you don't, never mind, if you don't save, you can build yourself, this one, this one 1 minute job, how long you take to build this one? Very fast, okay, never mind, if you don't save, just close. Okay, now let's try to build this one, maybe this one I want you to save, this one on page 5. Okay, page 5, right? Okay, let's do this. Now, first thing first, you can see how many indicators are there in this program? The three, right? Three indicators. I have one control, right? And there's another thing called constants. I'll show you. What is this constant? Now, first thing first, can you open a blank VI for me? Something like this. So you have a blank front panel and a blank block diagram, fresh, start from fresh. Then after we'll add some codes to it. Okay, now first thing, maybe we do this. I want you to right click on your function palette, which is on my right hand side, you can see on my screen here. Okay, I want to put a loop. Okay, let's introduce to you. You all know what's a while loop? May have heard before. While loop. Okay, sounds very familiar. But what is this thing? Okay, never mind. I'll show you first. Go to structures. Can you find this? Okay, let me zoom in for you. Can you find these structures? Okay, Ken? Okay, now I want you to navigate under the structures, right? There's this thing called while loop. Can you all see this? This thing. There, very big. See, super magnified for you. This one, while loop. Can you see? Okay, while loop. So I want you to drop one of these while loop into the block diagram as shown. So you should see something like this. Very big. Which one? Or you just resize. Okay, I just put one here. Is it okay? Now, what you would notice, now how to stop a while loop? You know what's a while loop? It means that a loop that will keep running, right? Because currently what you do is that you try to click the run button and you only run one time. But if you want that program to keep running, then you need to put a while loop around it until you tell him to stop, right? Then you introduce a stop button. Fair enough? Put a stop button. How to put the stop button? Very simple. Okay, you will notice that I will bring my wiring tool as shown here. You see the wiring tool? How to get the wiring tool again? One quick shortcut, press the shift key, right click on your mouse. That's a quick shortcut. If you're not comfortable with that, you can go to view, you can view the tools palette. Fine, I'm okay. Okay? Or you press the shift key, right click on your mouse. It will launch this tools palette. Okay? Bring the wiring tool. Bring this wiring tool to here. This is called the iteration condition terminal. This red dot here, what I call the red dot. Okay, I'll bring my wiring tool to here. Okay, I always right click on my mouse. Remember, right click. Okay, then you ask you, what do you want me to put? That view will ask you, right? Okay, very simple. What do you want? I want a control, right? Okay, I introduce a control. So I create a control. So if you create a control, that view will create a stop button for you. So you, okay, I'll show you again, one more time. So you bring the wiring tool, right click, wiring tool, bring this wiring tool to this terminal here. This thing will start to flash. Right click on your mouse, okay, right click, create control over here. Okay, once you create a control, that view automatically create a stop button for you. Now, this stop button appears here. At the same time, it's actually appearing at the front panel over here. Do you see this?
Yes,
this is the stop button. When I click stop, this program stops, terminates. Now, another question is, student always ask, sir, do I save the block diagram separately from the front panel? What do you think?
No
need to save two times. Save once only. Because if you go to file save, right, you are saving the entire thing. Okay, it will save the front panel, it will save the... Because these two things are one entity, right? They are together. And this is belong to this. They work together. So you save all. Okay? So after you have created the stop button, okay? Now, this program will be able to run. Right, if I kind of like resize this a little bit bigger, because you're in the class, right? I'll make this one a little bit bigger so you all can see. Okay, so I have quite a big stop button there. I have this while loop. Now I'm going to put the codes inside now. So what do I do? I want to follow the diagram. Alright, you have this one, right? The screenshot, right? Can you find this or not? Do you think you all can find? There's this function. Okay, you all know what is primary school days? We learn remainder. What is quotient? You all know remainder quotient? You all remember? If I do the long division, I have to divide, then later on I find that I got remainder, then the quotient is on top. You all remember? You know what I'm saying? You know what's... I think you all can remember. This one. Okay, let me just quickly, for the benefit of some of you. Let's say you divide, right? Long division, let's say 2, 2, 1, 0. Let's say you divide by 5. What do you do? This is the quotient. Right, the top part that you divide, right? Then you have the... You do, after you get this part, right? The last part that you cannot divide anymore, this is the remainder. So just to remind ourselves, this is the quotient. Okay, we are not going to do this long division. Let view will take care for us. Right, you know what I'm saying? When you do the division, right, you divide, right, 2 cannot, then 22, then it will be 4, right, here will be 20, then 2 and so on, right? So here, the final answer here is the remainder. Here is the quotient. So that's what you're trying to do. Okay, if you look at the block diagram here, okay, I need you to look for me this function called the divide, where you find remainder and quotient. Very simple. Right click on your mouse, go to numeric. Okay, you can see it. Where is it? You find it? Very simple. And then it's here, right? Then quotient and remainder. Okay, so you plug this number here. Okay, this function, this is a function, right? Plug this function into here. Now, let's do a simple one first. Okay, now, if you do not know what this function does, very simple, there's always help available. Okay, you can bring your cursor to this thing called a question mark here. Do you see this thing? Can you hover, click on this thing? Click on this question mark. So, what you do, you click on this, right? Then you bring your, this is called the context help. Context help. So you bring, after you click, right, you bring your cursor to that function that you want to see. There, you see this thing pop out? There, this thing pop out. This window. pops up, right? Yeah, then you have to click the question mark first at the top right hand corner. Okay, then you see this, right? This is called the context help. Tell me, explain to you what this function does. Simple. Okay, then I see, basically it computes this thing, right? Find the quotient and find the remainder. Okay, if you want a little bit more detail, you can always click on the detail help, then you will have another description. Okay, so it's quite simple, in a sense. So I know that this function will take in two input, right? One x, one y, right? So which divide by which, do you know? Which one divide by which one? Look at this, look at this. X divide by y, very good. Okay, so it's going to be x divide by y, right? Then it shows you here what? So the top one is the remainder, right? The bottom one is the quotient. Okay, so let's try something simple. Let's try really simple stuff. Okay, now let's say, I'll move this one away. I'm going to use back my wiring tool. Okay, you see my wiring tool? Okay, I want to create a control. So I bring my wiring tool to the input of the terminal there. Okay, I bring to the first terminal. There are two terminals, input terminals. I'll right click, create control. The first terminal, the X terminal, the one on top. Okay, I will create. This is called the X terminal, right? The first terminal, the inputs, in other words. Okay, yes, create a control. So this control will appear on the front panel. Very simple, nice and easy. Okay. Now, if I create a constant. Now, constants are fixed numbers. Constants are fixed numbers. Let's say if I right-click on this, but this time I create a constant. Constants are numbers, right now. For example, we learn pi, right? Pi is 3.142, right? That one is a constant, right? So I can create a constant if I wish to. So I create a constant here. So if I create a constant, right? Yeah, so I need to type some numbers, right? Maybe I put 5, You try that first, create a constant. Okay? So I type a 5 first. How to type the number here? Simple, use the tools palette, use the A2. The A2, the A means A for text. So I can type the text, change it here. Now I want to take a look at what is the output of this function first. So simply, right, because I got this function, right, I want to see what is the x and y, the output of this. So over here, the output, there are two terminals. I right click, create indicator. You know what I mean? I need to indicate, indicator means the output, right? Remember, not control anymore, the indicator is to display. So I created an indicator over here, and I call this the remainder. Okay, I change the name, call remainder. Then I create one more. Right click on the other input, the output, create indicator. I call this one the quotient. IQ stands for quotient. Quotient remainder. So let's try a number. I know it's going to divide by 5. So if I put 20, okay, what do you think is the output? Any remainder or not? If I run this little program. Any remainder? Can you all do this first? Okay, step by step. If you all too fast, please stop me. If you cannot. Too fast. Okay, slowly. Okay, something like this. Quotient and remainder. Okay, something not very quite basic stuff. So I'm going to take a number divided by 5, right? Then I find what's the remainder, find what's the quotient, that's all. At this point. So if I run this code, okay, I'm going to take 20, right? Divided by 5, right? So I would expect there will be no remainder, right? Remainder should be 0, quotient should be 4. Yes, very simple. Okay, we can see over here. Can you all do this? Constant. I put constant for the time being. At least to let you know. I can change to control if I want to. I can make it a control so that I can input the value. Is it okay? Can you all try to kind of run the program? This thing will be running continuously. Now, Another beautiful thing about lab view is this. I tell you, okay, you can turn on the light bulb. Do you see this thing? I call it the light bulb. Do you see there's a light bulb here? This thing is very, very useful, I tell you. This thing is called the highlight execution. This light bulb. Click on it. Click on the light bulb. Yeah, when you click on this light bulb, right, what you see is that you can see the flow of the program. You see, the things are, you can show you the data flow. You can see it with your eyes. You cannot do it in other language. If you do C programming, you can't see anything. You just see the final result. And you don't know what's going on inside. Do you see that? Then you can see, you see, what is going into here and then what is coming out from there. You can see, then I can see the constant 20 and 5. Which one? No, it's the result. These two are the automatically generated result. These two come out by itself one because it's the result. Do you see what I mean? This thing come out by itself. These two are the indicators or the result, right? After you do the division, it give you the remainder, give you the quotient. The result come out by itself. You cannot change this, remember. These are indicators. This is a control. Over here, this is a control. The user can change it. Why don't you move it now? Change the value when the program is running. Okay, bring your cursor to the here. Click on it. Don't worry, don't be shy. Click on the number here. Use this scroll key. Click on it. Change the digit. Now, if I take 23 divided by 5, I'm going to have remainder and quotient now. Do you see what I mean? I've already changed it when the program is running. I change this number, change the control. Do you see? Okay. Can y'all see? Okay, you can see this thing running. So it's very nice in a way. I can straight away see the program okay or not okay. I see, I know. Okay, are you comfortable here up to this point? Okay, I think we save also. I'll turn off the light bulb. Can I ask you to turn off if you don't want to see already, right? Please remember to switch it off. Switch off the light bulb, then you click stop. Okay, the program will terminate nicely for you. Is that okay? Oh, very good. Well done, you're following. Okay, now what I want to do, I want to just complete that code there. The little screenshot that we have on your page 5. Okay, let's try to work on this. Now, let's try to follow. I'm going to change the name of the X. I don't want to call it X anymore. I want to call it, I'm using the text tool again. Use the A2, text tool. Go to view, tools palette, tools palette. Okay, then you use the A2, okay, change the name. Call it total time in seconds. Okay, so let's do that. Okay, this is a thing, okay. Now, okay, I'm going to change the constant, right? Again, I'm using the A2, the text 2 to change this number here. So I don't want it to be 5 anymore. I'm going to change it to 3600. Okay, because it's minutes, right? Hours and minutes, right? 60 times 60. Okay, because it's 60 times 60. Right, minutes. 1 hour is 60 minutes. Okay, 1 minute is 60 seconds. I'm changing this to be seconds. So I put a little comment here. I can use the A2 to type some comments. You know what I mean? Seconds. I put a comment. I use the text tool, right? The A2 to type some comments here so that you know. You know what I mean? Can you follow so far? Which one? Which one? Repeat. Good. Please ask question. How to get this one, is it? Yes, I use the A2. There, you see this A2? I selected the A. the A, the text 2. Then I can type things inside. The A 2, yes, correct. Good. Okay, so I do this. Okay. I'm almost going to be finishing quite soon. So what I need to do is, okay, now this one, right, can I ask you to break the wire first, break it off, select the wire and cut it out, and bring it to this side. Okay, you know what I mean? Can, because I want to follow the figure, ma. I need to try to follow. Okay, so I'm doing the first part. Okay, so follow the first part. I can also do. I need to make another one, right? Okay, okay, too fast. Okay, please stop me. Yes, I want you to basically build the diagram. That's all. That's why my intention. Follow and build that diagram. Can you try to do that? Okay. Select the wire, then just press delete. You'll break it. Okay. We just following the diagram, because I know you understand. You all have different speed, Each of you are doing at different speed, so I'm trying to adjust and try to cater for everybody. Okay, I'll do my best, Please stop me, okay, if you are stuck, raise your hand. Then I will pause. Ask question. Okay, so what I do, the next thing is to put another one. Numeric, put the same function again here, right? Because the first one is to get the hours. So I connect to this one, change the name. Hours. Almost done, almost done. Come. Persevere, we are almost there. Okay, this function, I get the hours, right? Because I take the total time in second divided by 3,600, I will get this one has the number of hours. Okay, then now I need to figure out how to get the minutes and also the seconds. So I need to put one more. Okay, I need to put one more. So the output of this, which one? The wiring tool, is it? The wiring, okay, tools palette again. Shift right click on your mouse. There. The wiring, this one, that look like solder, you know, solder? Solder is like a wire, right? There. The solder. The solder is to the wire. This arrow is the position, you can move things. Can? Okay, so then I try to follow the diagram and wire. So I connect the remainder to the top part here. Yeah, this one I will change to right click, create a constant. Okay, slowly. Right click, create a constant. Okay, right click on your mouse, create a constant. Yeah, okay, then I type 60, right? Because I follow the diagram. 60. Yep. So I will just change the name, this indicator. I will change it to seconds. Which one? This one, is it? This box, which box? Is it this one? Which box? No need. Yeah, seconds. Then I create this one. Maybe you all need help. This one, create indicator again. This one, bring the wiring tool to the terminal here. Right click, create indicator. Okay, done already. Finish. Okay, I will come and help you all. Minutes. Okay, so I have hours, minutes, and seconds. I'm done. So I need to just adjust this part here. So hours, okay, minutes and seconds. Create indicator. Okay, indicator. So if I tell you, if I type in some numbers just to try, 3,600, it will be only give me 1 hour, right? Because you see, you just done a simple little nice program, converting seconds into hours, minutes, and seconds. So if I type in 3,600 seconds, it's only just 1 hour. Is that okay? This one? So try to change it. I can change the total time. Then you can check. Hey, by the way, I didn't tell you, just some of you came late. I recorded my lecture, so-called. Y'all didn't know there's a recording device in front of me here. There's a camera. I'm using my phone camera. There's a robotic arm that keeps moving. As I take, yeah, seriously, in front. Then there's a microphone here. So what I'll do is I'll record it. I probably upload it in YouTube so that if you want to revise, y'all don't know which part, it's good for you. I don't know. I still haven't figured out where the best place to put, honestly. Of course, YouTube is not the best, But if I keep it private, then only y'all got the link, then y'all can see, ma. Up to you, y'all wants me to post, I can post anywhere. Where you want to put it. Okay, so I'll try to do it this way. So at least y'all got some things to refer. Because sometimes, I understand students may miss out things. Then y'all don't know how to do this part. Then at least you got that lecture, you can quickly go and see which part, how you do it. This part, something like that. Okay? Okay, done. Can you try out, pilot test your program, run it, put some value and make sure you get this correct. If you put 3,600, right, you will get 1 hour definitely. No minutes, no seconds. That's for sure, right? Okay, then you try, can you try the number inside the notes, that one? What is the number? 32200. You just check, make sure if I type in this seconds, 32,200 seconds, right? I should get 8 hours, 56 minutes, and 40 seconds. Okay, so just try it. Just a simple exercise to get you familiar. The objective is to get you familiar with the environment. Yeah, okay. Can you help? Okay, let me pause this thing first.